What's going on, lads and ladettes, and welcome back to episode 55.
This is a 55. Big one. This is your number. We should probably call this one the Ryan McGee episode.
This was my number. This was my number. And remember that, you know what else it is? Remember that old YouTube video, Sh 55?
No.
You ever see that one?
No.
It's just a weird video. I don't know, man. I've been like Pee Wee Hockey. Some guy on my team would like sing this song called Sh 55. And it was like this weird YouTube thing, man. I can't even explain it. It was nonsense. But it was kind of like a viral video. I guess like 12-year-olds found it funny.
Or like, yeah, it's like, do you remember the duck song? Like a duck walked up
to yeah, it, it's like a similar said, thing hey. To that.
Okay. Yeah. Got any grapes?
It's like a still, yeah, it's like, what the hell? But yeah, like it was one of those ones, 55. If you know, you know. But yeah, that was my number. But we have a couple athletes here. Philly, actually, it was OC, right? You said had this idea?
Yeah, so OC texted me and said he had an idea for us. He said, here's like the general basis, broke it down, and then said, boys, have at it. And just like said we could use this. But I wanted to give, like, we got to give him credit for coming up with the idea.
Yeah,
it wasn't ours, but great idea. So basically, for a bunch of the episodes we've done, when we come to pick a player that represents this number, we've come across ones with multiple guys who wore the number. And like 55 is a pretty iconic number in terms of like professional athletes who have worn them. But for this one, for example, two guys who wore number 55 that kind of like stood out, and even OC pointed out in his example, was Russell Martin and Dikembe Mutombo. So to give you guys an idea of what it is that we're going to do is, when we come across episodes with multiple people who wore this number, McGee and I are going to pick some type of topic, and we will debate between the two people who wore that number who would win in this type of competition that we put them up in. So it's not going to be the same thing every time, and it's not going to be the same athletes, it's not going to be the same battles, but we will decide what the battle is going to be that they go head-to-head in. So, for example, a 100-meter sprint or a drinking contest, push-up contest, who would win in a Royal Rumble, like stuff like that. Maybe even we'll do like a swimming contest or like juggling. Like we'll just pick whatever it may be.
Oh, three-legged race.
Yeah, and we'll put them up head-to-head. Race. So for this one to start, just because I feel like we can get into some good debates on in terms of this topic,
okay,
is Russ Martin versus Dikembe Mutombo, the battle of the 55s, who can drink more beers? So, McGee, do you want to start us off between Russ Martin and Dikembe Mutombo, who can drink more beers and why?
Okay, can I get a weight check, please, for both of them? Can I need some stats to go off of?
So, in the Canadian corner, weighing in at 215 pounds, 5'10", is professional baseball player and former Blue Jays catcher Russell Martin. In the opposing corner, a 7'2", 260-pound freak from the NBA, known for his blocking abilities and his iconic finger wag, Dikembe Mutombo.
Okay. You know, it is hard to bet against a 7'2" freak of nature.
Yes.
Like, this guy's an absolute unit. 7'2", 260. But as much as he's got that Andre the Giant factor going on, we've all heard those legendary stories about Andre the Giant pounding 108 beers in a night.
Yeah.
But I think I got to give this one to Russell Martin. He's a good Canadian boy, as Don Cherry would say. Good Canadian boy. I mean, he's built, man.
Yeah.
5'10", but 215. Like, yeah. Yeah. And I think he's got that Canadian. I think he's just got that. He's probably grown up drinking more beer as a Canadian. I feel like that's just more. I don't know, man. I feel like Dikembe likes wine. I feel like he seems like a classier guy. I think Russell just gives me that grittier vibe. So I'm going to go with the Canadian boy. Russell Martin can pound more beer than Dikembe.
Okay. I kind of wanted to give it to Russ Martin too because of the Canadian edge factor. And just like 5'10", 215. This guy's kind of built like a mini fridge. Just,
yeah, bro.
You know, like you can tell that guy puts back beers. But I do think I'm going to have to give it to Mutombo because the sheer height of this guy, like he has so much, I don't know if like surface area to just disperse the alcohol throughout. Like, that's I feel like he would just hold a beer can in his hand and it would look like he's drinking those little mini sodas. And he would just be like slamming them back like nobody's business. You wouldn't even be able to see the beer in his monster mitt of a hand. And he would just be slamming them down. And it's not like he's necessarily skinny. Like, he's not the biggest guy.
No, he's not.
260. 70? He's a frame, man. He's a frame. So
he is a friend. I think he, like, could you're do right, it. Like you said, it's the surface area and it's the stamina. I feel like maybe Russ Martin can pound about quicker.
Right.
But I think Dikembe Mutombo, like slow and steady, might win the race with this one. But I'm sticking with my guns, going with Russ Martin, but I know what you mean and that's a valid point.
I do also think he's got that Andre the Giant comparison like you threw out there. Like, it's hard to look at a guy like Andre the Giant, see how many beers he can put back and say like, oh, this guy who's I don't know what Andre the Giant's weight is. It's definitely more than 260.
I think it was like 360. I think it was 7-3, 360 or something like that.
Oh my god. Okay. That's a monster human. But yeah, like I think he could just put them back like nobody's business. So I'm gonna have to give
Oh my god, never mind. 7'4", 520 pounds.
Oh my god, he doubles Mutombo's weight. He doubles Mutombo's weight. Oh my god. Okay, so maybe it's not exactly the same comparison factor then. I might have to rethink this because Russ. Oh my god, man. Russ Martin's like proportions now, it kind of changes the perspective in my opinion.
He's on half of Andre the Giant. Like kind of close to the same height, half the weight.
You might have just swung me there. I think you might have just swung me. You know what? That's it. Like we're clear cut winner, Russ Martin here. McGee, I've turned sides. I'm on your team here. Russ Martin could do it because I'm just thinking like proportionally too. Honestly, Mutombo might be too skinny.
He might be too tall
and lanky to do it. Whereas 5'10", 215, like he's got. I think you're right. I think it's Russ Martin and he's Canadian. So like, yeah, Russ Martin wins this one.
The only other 55, I think they could give Russ Martin a run for his money was me last night on Halloween.
did you put on a clinic?
Oh my God. Did I ever? Yeah. It was just a day. It was a blue moon. What else could I say? It was a blue moon last night.
Yeah. A little spooky.
And just, I don't know if it was the moon or the tides that did it. I think I'm a firm believer in zodiac signs now just because of how last night went. It was just a
really
disaster. Yeah.
Really.
In the best way. It was a great night, but it was a blue moon. Look it up. First since 1944, I think.
I saw that. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Didn't go outside to look at it. Couldn't make it outside to look at it, but I'm sure it was beautiful.
But so you went as Simon and Garfunkel, yeah?
Yeah. Yeah.
Your hair is still seeing the effects of it.
Yeah, I mean, my headphones are kind of weighing it down right now, but I got the full fro going.
Yeah,
but I think I'm just gonna let the hair go. I mean, who am I trying to impress? My Zoom class? No. So I think I'm just gonna let the hair go. I may have to join you with the beard and see if how long I can grow that because yours is coming in pretty nice.
It's just patchy. That's the only thing. Like I got these little holes going on like underneath. It's kind of like I've got these almost like mutton chops, like Wolverine-ish.
Yeah, but, yeah. That looks good though. I mean, it comes far enough up your cheek. Like when I grow facial hair, it stops like that, like on the side of my face. And you can already see the line.
Yeah.
And it's not even like it's not on my face. It's just on my like chin-ish area.
Right. It's not. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I'll have to like let it go. We'll see.
You got to get one of those Swedish, the Copenhagen grooming system that you see on the Instagram ads sometimes.
Yes.
Little spiky roll, like poke your face.
And it's supposed to activate the hair growth.
Yeah, activate the follicles. Yeah, get that going.
Okay. Maybe I do have to do that. But last night was Halloween. And you went as Simon and Garfunkel, right? You went with your with your buddy. How was it, McGee? How was Halloween? How was your COVID?
It was good. It was good, man. It was a lot of fun. We It was just a day. We went for a walk around the park, like when we first got up. Got out, got some fresh air, and then came back. We just posted up on the couches and just shot the shit with the boys, because I had a buddy who came up from up back home. Reed had a buddy, two buddies who came up from home. And yeah, we just had like a bunch of the lads over, just kind of shooting the shit. And then we invited some girls over, kind of got together, just had a little party.
Yeah.
And it was fun. It was just a lot of fun, man. Just like, I kind of like the smaller ones, because it's just like a close group of friends, like no pressure, no like grease balls there ruining the night for anyone else. Like yeah. Everybody's just positive and upbeat, ready to have fun.
Yeah,
so
that's perfect.
I think it was perfect. It was the perfect night. And then everybody, we just went to bed just weirdly late for no reason. I had the greatest sleep. I woke up this morning, like no hangover, nothing. I'm like, oh my God, like I feel like $1 million.
Yeah.
Then we went to this like, Reed's a big Manchester United supporter.
Yeah.
So we went to this like English pub called the Duke of Wellington, got some like Eggs Benedict, a couple of pints, and watched the Man U game this afternoon. And yeah, it was just great. We got back and now everybody's like taking a nap, like in... Now we're kind of feeling the effects, but
yeah, you're in recovery mode. It's that like late afternoon hangover where it just hits you out of nowhere. Yeah. You're like, whoa, wait a minute. That wasn't supposed to happen. I thought I avoided you, but it's it's just like the Halloween vibe. It's spooky. It came out of nowhere. It's just snuck up on you. So we're recording on Sunday, November 1st. So last night was Halloween. And we kind of wanted to stick with the Halloween vibe for this episode. So we have a bunch of Halloween topics prepared. Mm-hmm. First thing I want to get into, because I kind of was going to put together a list of like best Halloween candy and like go off of that. But then I started having these random candies in there that I was like, okay, I don't know if these really fit into there. So I sent it to you prior to, so we could kind of prepare our own list. But this one, the list I want to start with here is candy that you have at Halloween and no other time. So maybe
this one
you have it at other times, but like it's prominent at Halloween and that's kind of it. So is there any that you want to start with here?
Easy. This is an easy one for me, because like as soon as you sent me that text being like, hey, this is something we could talk about, like the first thing that came to my mind and the only thing I will like take this to my grave: rockets.
Yeah,
rockets are the one candy I only have on Halloween. I never even see them in stores, not on Halloween.
Right.
But they're just, they're probably my favorite candy too. Like,
oh, really?
They're like, I love them. I like them a lot, man. Like, I love rockets, but I only see them on Halloween. And that's like a Halloween candy specifically.
Yeah.
They're not like coffee crisps or Kit Kats where you like see them all the time throughout the year. Rockets are they're just such a special thing. I hold near and dear to my heart.
So I have rockets on my list, which is, so that's pretty good there. Another one I have on here, which I hadn't really thought of, I think it was my dad brought up, was remember the little packs that you get of two-piece gum? It's the Chiclets.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you get like I get those on Halloween and no other time. Like you're never out in the store and you just see Chiclets, or you're never like people don't like give you candy at like any other time, you get Chiclets. Like it's always the different types of chocolate bars or whatever, but Chiclets is just Halloween. Like that's just a Halloween thing.
Remember that, like, this is like kind of way off base and kind of dark, but remember that like thing, like when we were growing up, there was some like, oh, be careful for like getting like candy that's already been opened or whatever. And there's this one candy going around that like caused a bunch of kids to choke because it like expanded in their throats. It was some like sort of Asian candy that like they'd give it to children. And it would like expand in their throat and make them choke. And they had like, I don't know if it was a recall or like, it was a whole. Because in my neighborhood, like there was like some cases of like there were some scares with this candy going around. It was like a like some sort of drop or like I don't know, but so my parents were like, "Babe, be careful. If you, this is what it looks like, if you see this in your candy, like notify us. Don't eat it." And I'm like, "Okay." I had to be on edge that Halloween. I didn't want to choke and die, man. It's Halloween. I'm out with my friends, like me and Michael Simony, ripping up the town. with our dads just following close behind, looking out for any choking hazards.
Dude, that's wild. I don't think I ever heard of that.
I got a chocolate bar in my candy one time that was stapled shut. Like someone had opened with it and like tampered with it, probably. Why else would there be a staple through it?
Yeah, that's weird, man.
Like, just, right? My mom's like, oh, no. Like, we're not even.
Yeah,
like,
right to the garbage. There. Thank you, though. Yeah. Little did you know there was like a $100 bill inside that they had opened up and wrapped the chocolate in. No. Okay, so another one that I had thrown in here, nerds.
Yes.
Because I don't really see them. I've seen them kind of thing, but like I don't really get them any other time other than Halloween.
Not so much recently. Well, obviously I haven't been trick-or-treating recently, but like I feel like nerds were a more popular thing years ago.
Yeah.
And less common today.
Yeah. That's possible. Do you got any others here?
Let's see. I would always get like Humpty Dumpty chips. And like only, like I have chips all the time, which is fine. But like for some reason, Humpty Dumpty exclusively on Halloween.
Yes,
what's that
man.
About? They're not even the best type of chip.
No, okay. And you know what I have in my list here too, and I put Humpty Dumpty / Old Dutch.
Yes, Old Dutch.
And just on Halloween. Just on Halloween, those surface, and I get like 10 bags of Old Dutch and Humpty Dumpty. I'm like, what?
Exactly. What do you want? Like, the worst chips in the world? Are you kidding me? Oh my god! Like, you couldn't even like hook me up with the Doritos or like sweet chili heat. Like,
yeah,
none of that. No Ruffles, all dressed. Just
no. Yeah, it's just Humpty Dumpty and Old Dutch. Okay, I also have on here Airheads. I feel like Airheads for me was more specific to Halloween. Like you'd get those little plastic or not plastic, but like the little packages with like a one piece of Airhead in it.
Oh yeah.
You know what I'm talking about? Like that little like square Airheads thing. And it's just like the sugar taffy kind of, I feel like those just came in my Halloween bags. Like you wouldn't really get those any other time.
I just thought of another one that I'm going to say later, but with the Airheads, they weren't as common in my neighborhood.
Okay.
Like I've probably had more Airheads going to the convenience store and buying them myself. Cause they were like 5 cents or whatever than I had in my Halloween candy. But one candy, again, like similar to Rockets that I only see on Halloween and get a lot of, like a strange amount of.
Yeah.
Are Tootsie Rolls.
Yes. Yes.
Dude, Tootsie Rolls are everywhere in my Halloween candy.
Yep.
Everywhere.
Yep. Do you like Tootsie Rolls?
So I don't know. Okay. I used to hate them. Yep. I used to hate them. But then I would always like save them because like, I wouldn't want to eat them, right? So I'd like, go through my whole like Halloween candy in my pillowcase, dump it on the floor. And like, of course, my dad would come over and like take his share.
Yeah, rummage.
But like, yeah, you'd rummage. He loved the Rockets too, so he'd probably steal most of my Rockets. But I'd always be left over with like 100 Tootsie Rolls because I wouldn't eat them. I'd save them to the end. And then I'm just like, oh, I got to put it off. And once Halloween, I just sat there, Tootsie Roll after Tootsie Roll. I'm like, the deeper I got into it, it was like, you know what? These aren't half bad. And then, like, I actually started liking Tootsie Rolls. So I would never go out and buy them myself.
Yeah.
But they're not my least favorite Halloween candy.
Right. Okay.
They beat out Old Dutch and Humpty Dumpty. That's
yeah. Cool. Yeah. I back Tootsie Rolls. I like them. Like, they come in my Halloween bag. Yeah, I can crush them. Another one I had on here, and I feel like this one might be a little more controversial because I do get them sometimes, like, other than when it was Halloween, you go trick-or-treating. And I do like them any time of the year, not just at Halloween. But Jolly Ranchers.
Yeah.
Like, I don't just casually go to the store and buy, like, a bag of Jolly Ranchers. But they would come in my Halloween bag of, like, just you'd get, like, somebody threw like a individual handful of Jolly Ranchers. Yeah, like, just the individually wrapped ones in your bag.
Yeah, Jolly Ranchers were a huge one for me, too. They were all over the place. And it's just a lot of those individual candies, like just the one lozenge or the one little like piece of taffy. A lot of those little, just the tiny ones. But Jolly Ranchers were good. Like I'm not the biggest. I'm more of a Starburst guy.
Oh.
Jolly Ranchers just don't do it for me. But like they're so common. They're so common.
Yeah, I don't know if there's any others that I can really think of. Like I kind of had, Butterfingers and Wonder Bar on here.
Wonder Bar is
another
one.
Those like a good amount in Halloween, and maybe it's just personal thing. I don't see them for the rest of the year, but like I felt like those were good ones that I see you see on Halloween like a lot. They come up.
Okay, if we had to come up with a list of the top three, like let's narrow our choices down. Like my ranking would be Old Dutch, Rockets, Tootsie Roll, and Old Dutch in no particular order as Halloween exclusive candies.
Okay, mine would be Chiclets, the two-piece gum, Old Dutch, and Rockets. Yeah, I'm going to have to steal two of yours, but I'm just going to swap in.
No, but I mean,
swap in the two piece gum.
Yeah. The two piece gum. I like it is, it's kind of a new, not even good gum.
No, it loses flavor in like 5 seconds.
Yeah. That's the worst thing ever.
Yeah. You put one in, wait till you put one in, wait till the flavor is gone, then put the other one in 10 seconds later, flavor of both is gone. And you're just chewing some, like, I don't even know. You're just chewing some piece of rubber almost.
It's like a cow chewing a cud. Or whatever the cows chew.
Yeah.
Trying to like,
yeah.
If you swallow that thing, it'll be in your stomach for the rest of your life.
Yeah, exactly.
Just, like, solidify in there.
Okay. So now, other than Halloween candy that you just see at Halloween, I want to get into best candy.
Master Debaters.
I love master debating.
And like, I kind of put it as best Halloween candy, but okay. I don't know if like it's not specific to Halloween. It's more so just if you're going out for Halloween, these are your favorite things that you want to get. So I feel like the way we should do this one is we'll give like a top five, and then we can kind of go through maybe some honorable mentions or discuss ones that we think the other person missed. So I'll start it off and I'll give my top five here. And I think this one is in order for me. Okay. So number one, actually I'll go reverse order. I'll go reverse order to build some anticipation. So coming in at number five for me, and this one is, I feel like more of an underrated one. And I found out the other day that it's specific to Canada, is the crunchy, like the, I think it's the crispy crunch or whatever.
Crispy comes crunch.
Blue. Oh. Yeah. I love those ones.
They're like zigzag wrapping kind of like. It's
yeah. The, yeah. The blue, red and white. Yeah.
Yeah.
Love those ones. Delicious. Number four. So the rest are kind of like mainstream ones here, but hard to pass. Number four, Aero. The Aero bar.
The Aero was a nice break in between regular chocolate bars, just because it had the little holes, and it was like
it
made room for it's a light chocolate.
Yeah, it's a light snack chocolate between chocolates. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, so number three, Kit Kat. That's okay. Just like, I feel like for me,
it's
that's
a classic.
Like
a simple, it's a classic.
Yeah, classic go-to. Number two, Coffee Crisp.
Okay.
And coming in at the number one spot, the King Daddy topper, the chocolate above all chocolates, Reese's Peanut Butter Cups. I feel like Reese's Peanut Butter Cups might be the best chocolate like all time. They're good. I love, you can get like the little mini cups, you can get the regular size cups, you can get the mega cups, and then you can get like the 2 pound cups, you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Like, they're just, they're so good. They're so good. I love Reese's Peanut Butter Cups. So that's my top five. Crunchy, Aero, Kit Kat, Coffee Crisp, and Reese's Peanut Butter Cups.
Okay. That's a good list. That's a good list. I'm going to go same thing as you, reverse from five to one.
Yeah.
Coming in at number five, not going to have any delay here. It's the Tootsie Roll.
Okay.
I mean, it's consistent. It gets the job done, and it's a nice break for like the chocolatey sweets.
Yeah.
Number four, I'm going to go with the – I'm going to put Crispy Crunch at four because I completely forgot about it. It wouldn't have been on my list, but you brought it up, and it's a killer chocolate bar.
Yeah, so good, man.
Yeah, it's so good. I'm going to go with number three is Aero for kind of the same reasons you outlined. Intermission chocolate bar, light. Yeah. It's good. It's a good bar. Number two, I'm going to go with Rockets as my number two. Again, a nice break from the chocolate. It is sugar. It's really sugary. So you got to brush your teeth like eight times.
Yeah.
But they're just a staple in my Halloween bag. And then number one. My number one favorite chocolate bar, not as much anymore, but just kind of like reminiscing. I was a huge Caramilk guy.
Oh,
I loved Caramilk, man.
Caramilk's so good.
Yeah, so Caramilk's probably the number one on my list.
Okay, so break that down again. You're 5-1.
5-1. It went Tootsie Roll, Crispy Crunch, Aero, or no?
Yeah.
Aero, Rockets, and Caramilk. Number one.
Okay. Nice. Like, so we had some diversity in the list. I think the diversity. Only crossover was Arrow and Crunch, but we had them in different spots on the list.
I think that like my all time favorite chocolate bar is a Toblerone, but like you're not gonna see any of those on Halloween.
No, that is
an elite chocolate.
Yeah, oh, man. Toblerone is so hard to pass up. Every year on Christmas,
it's such a Christmas chocolate for some reason.
Yes. Every year on Christmas, that's what my sisters and I get is the massive Toblerone bar.
Oh my god.
It's just incredible. And my parents like wrap it up in the wrapping paper as if we don't know like what it's in there.
You see like the triangular prism and you're like,
Yeah, that's probably all time. But yeah, not really like a Halloween or like a year-round thing. It's just so good. Okay, I had kind of honorable mentions here. O. Henry's, Snickers, yep. Twix, M&M's, yep. And Smarties.
Okay, Smarties should have been on my list.
You think?
I don't know why Smarties weren't on my list. I would probably replace Smarties with Aero Bar.
Oh, you're making a change. Are you making a change to your list?
No, believe it. But Smarties should have been there. Smarties honorable mention. I'm happy with that. That's fine.
Would you take Smarties over M&M's?
Yes, I would.
Interesting. I never really thought there was like that much of a difference. And then it was the other day I was listening to the radio and for some reason it was on sports radio. They were talking about Smarties versus M&M's. And the more I started thinking about it, I was like, yeah, there is a difference between the two.
Oh, there's a huge difference between the two.
I think Smarties is over M&M's for me as well, but like there's nothing wrong with M&M's. Like
nothing wrong at all. Nothing.
And there's diversity in M&M's too.
Yeah, then you can get the peanuts, like the different types of chocolate, and there's Smarties. Like every now and then you can get the different color packs based on the seasons. Like you get the Halloween Smarties that are only black and orange or whatever. Yeah. But they're the same no matter what. M&M's are always a treat, and I don't think I'd put, like, you know how some people put M&M's in their popcorn at the movie theater?
Yes.
I couldn't say I would do that with Smarties.
Okay. Okay, so Smarties would just have to be eaten on its own. Like, it's its separate entity. Okay.
Yeah, because I think the packaging they come in isn't big enough to do that thing, too.
Right. Fair enough. And then I hadn't even thought about caramel. Like, I left it off my list, but it definitely deserves an honorable mention. I love the caramel.
I love caramel milk. And then like, another great one, another staple is the Hershey's cookies and cream.
Yep, I was just going to say that one, so good. Hershey's is hard to miss, too.
It is.
Dark chocolate, milk chocolate. Cookies and cream. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Just delightful.
Shout out Hershey's. Good job, fellas. Keep it up.
Yeah. So those are our best Halloween candies. And candies that you have at Halloween.
I have a cavity. I have a cavity after finishing this conversation.
Yeah, I'm on a sugar high just talking about it.
Yeah.
Like I was just on like a company trip this weekend. I get home and there's one of those boxes of the Nestle, like 100-pack of the mini chocolate bars.
Oh, yeah.
Just sitting on the counter and like looked in and like, grab some.
Did your family hand out candy to trick-or-treaters this year?
No.
Or were there many of them? Like,
no, my mom said that only one person came to the door.
Yeah,
they didn't answer.
I haven't even like checked my family yet, but like they're like, I don't think we're turning on the lights this year. Like, it's so sad then because my house was alive on Halloween, like growing up. Like, I'd have, like, the decorations out. Like, my parents would be in costume, like, handing the candy out to kids in the neighborhood. But then more recently, it's just been, like, in the past couple of years when I was home playing hockey and whatnot, I'd be home for Halloween. And I'd see, like, kids come to the door, like, just, like, wearing no costumes and just like, their bags. I was like, well, dude, what the hell?
Are you doing?
Yeah, they're 14, too. It's like, you're too old for this, and you're not getting a costume, man.
Yeah, I get
and
it.
And then there'd be, like, there'd be, like, four a night, too. Like, only four people come to the door, which is kind of sad. I'm like, dude, the street used to be, like, bustling with kids.
Yeah.
Damn sure. You got to keep COVID into account, too. So
Yes.
But.
Okay, do you want to talk about, do you have, like, a favorite Halloween memory or funniest Halloween memory, maybe from trick-or-treating or when you got older and you went to like a Halloween party or something like that? Do you have any of those?
I've got
one that I will probably never forget for the rest of my life. Like, it is so funny, and it's one of those ones where when you tell people, it's like it probably seems like you're bullshitting, like there's no way this could be real.
I got
like it's just so dumb. And like, I would never like make this up. Like, there's just no reason to make this up.
Yeah.
So basically, I think in the last episode I had put out a picture, or no, it was in the one with Alex and Vivian. I put a picture up of my Halloween costume. I went with like two of my best friends from elementary school. We went as the Three Musketeers. And the three of us went, and we went with one of my buddies' younger cousins. He was like 2 years younger than us, I think. And so we're walking around, we're trick-or-treating, we're kind of getting close to the end, and we're coming down the street like a couple away from mine. And my buddy says, he's like, do you think we could stop at this house? Like, we knew the kid from elementary school. We were still in elementary school, probably grade 7. He's like, do you think we stop at this guy's house? Like, I have to go to the washroom. Think they'll let me in? Like, yeah, sure. We might as well check. So, like, this is the part where it's so ridiculous. It's just, I will never forget the sound and the image of this happening. So basically, we get up to this guy's door. We knock on the door, and like, the parents know who we are. The kid knows who we are. Knock on the door. Parents open the door. They've got the bowl of candy. Like, trick or treat, whatever. They hand us the candies. And then my buddy goes, do you think that I could use the washroom? The parents say, yeah, sure, no problem. My buddy goes to step into the house. And as he takes the step up over like that little front step where the door kind of goes, he just faints face first into the, you know, those round metal candy bowls?
Yeah.
Face first. And it makes like that little gong noise when his face hits the candy bowl. The dad drops the candy bowl. Candy scatters all over the floor. And then this guy just hits the deck. Candy everywhere, bowls on the ground. And he's just like laying there, like eyes closed. Me, my other friend, and the other guys who's fainted now, his younger cousin, we're just standing there and we're like, what do we do? Like, we've never seen this guy faint before, and we hung out with him all the time. So it's not like we would be like, oh, maybe this something happens and we don't know. But like, no, like there's no way. We should have at least been able to anticipate this. I have no idea what's happened. No idea what to do. And we're kind of just like standing waiting. We're like, and then he just like gets up, and the dad's like, are you okay? And he goes, yeah, can I use your washroom? And the dad looks at him of this house and he goes, we don't have one. And then just like sends us back out the door.
What the hell, man?
Like, we were like, what a sequence of events. Like, what just went down? What is going on? Are you okay? Why did you just do that? What just happened? Like, what is happening right now? What just happened with our washroom?
Yeah, like, where did it go?
No, we don't have
real life. Yeah.
And then we were just gone. We were like, so we just like hurried back to my house, and he went to the washroom because it was like a couple of streets away or whatever, like two streets away. But like, and we were all three of us like in our Three Musketeers, and this guy just takes a nosedive, like faint face first into the candy bowl. Could have missed the candy bowl too, you know, but it's just that added element of the little gong noise off the bowl, like candy everywhere.
The disappearing bathroom.
No, like, we don't have one. It was like 30 seconds ago. You said this guy could use it. That was why he came in the house.
Yeah. Oh my God.
I'll never forget that though.
That's absurd. I can't believe that the guy just randomly like let you guys go on your way without like making sure he was okay. Like, this guy literally just like passed out.
Yeah.
And what are the Three Musketeers? Like Athos, Porthos, and Aramis. I think those are their names. But one of the lads just goes down. Dad without no concern for the kids. I'm assuming you guys are relatively young, like at this
probably point. Like 11 or 12.
Yeah, so, and this guy's like, oh, the guy just randomly fainted, gets up, and you're like, okay, like, shoot, not my problem.
Get out of the house.
Yeah, what the hell?
It was wild. I'll never forget it, man.
That's crazy. That's actually crazy. I have a story too that's whack, and I'm exposing the shit out of myself because like I wasn't 11 or 12, I was like 17, 18.
Okay.
Eight, maybe even 19. I don't know. But basically, it was Halloween. A couple of my teammates and I from Aurora, we go up to Laurier for Halloween. We go get our costumes. We have like the green light after a weekend or whatever, and we just wanted to have some fun. And we go up, drink a bit. We like go to my brother's apartment at the time. and we like have a little pre there, just playing beer pong, whatever, hanging out. And then we go out to like a bar or something and like continue the night there.
Yeah.
And then at the end of the night, I like regroup with my buddies and I'm like, okay, like where are we going to sleep now? Like, that's, we got to figure that out.
Yeah.
So then I text my brother. I'm like, yo, can we crash on the couch? He's like, oh, my roommates like last minute had like their buddies come up. So they're taking the couch now. So you can sleep at like my girlfriend's place on her futon. And I'm like, okay, that's fine with me.
Yeah, that works.
Yeah, that works. Like, it's just a place to crash or whatever.
Yeah.
So I go with my buddies. We show up to his girlfriend's apartment. Like, she knew me barely. And
you
then
love
she
you.
Had no you knew yeah basically, and then had no idea who my buddies are. But she was like gracious enough to let us into her home and like yeah like get us all set it up with like we set up the sheets and pillows and whatnot.
Yeah,
there's just three guys just like on this like, scrunched together on this like futon. So that's fine. I'm still in my priest costume at this point. Like Father Ryan was just like just sleeping on this couch, and then I wake up the next morning, and I was like not in the same clothes. I'm like, look down, I'm like, not in my costume anymore. I'm like, pardon me? Like, I walked in fine. I went to bed. I wake up, not in my costume. And my buddies look at me and they go, McGee, what the hell was that last night? What the hell was that?
Oh, no.
And I'm like, what are you talking about? And apparently, there were some noises being made in the kitchen. And I wake up and I'm sleepwalking. I'm in my priest costume, sleepwalking. In the middle of this kitchen, and apparently I climb up on the kitchen counter on all fours. I get on all fours on top of the kitchen counter.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I guess looking for a comfier place to sleep. So I'm like a goddamn kitten, like a cat, doing one of those circle things, like before I lay down on the top of this kitchen counter. I'm like knocking plates and dishes over. Like I knocked one of the mugs on the ground and it shattered.
Oh,
and
no.
Like they wake up and I'm just like making noise, like making weird ass like sleepwalk noises. And they're like, dude, get your ass up. Like they pulled me off of the counter, got me out of my priest costume, put me back to bed, and I had zero recollection. I didn't even believe it. I'm like, what the hell? I was just a cat randomly, like, just on the counter? Like, what the hell? I don't, no way. There's no way. And they showed me all the damage I had done up there, and I'm like, okay, like, maybe it's true.
Maybe.
So, yeah, that's the probably the most iconic Halloween that I've ever had in my life.
Interesting. But,
yeah, it was ridiculous.
It's just maybe it was just a spooky Halloween thing. Something got into you when you guys were out.
Another blue moon.
Yeah, it was a blue moon type thing. that's actually what I think you might have told that story on here before, but that is so hilarious. Like just wandering around in a priest costume, acting like a cat. Like, that's just so funny. And I think it's funnier too. Like, you could have just been a drunk idiot like doing this. But no,
yeah,
like
I went
to bed
and bed.
Just were sleepwalking, and it just happened to coincide
with
Halloween and the fact that you're drinking. Had nothing with you to do with
in
you
a
being
strangers.
Like,
and then one of the girls got up from bed, heard the smashing. Just a girl, she never met me in my life. No idea. This strange man's on her counter. Like, what the hell? Like, imagine her point of view. Like what? Like imagine walking out of your own house and seeing a stranger on the counter.
Yeah. What do you like? How do you? What do you even do?
How
do you
terrifying.
React to that? Yeah.
I don't know. I paid. I reimbursed the $25 or whatever for the mug. So
yeah,
we're on good terms.
Good guy move. Everything's good.
Yeah.
Nice. All good. Nice. do you have any go-to Halloween movies or anything that like you associate with Halloween?
I not one in particular. There are a few that I kind of like. I like the Michael Myers series, like, that like franchise. I don't know. I kind of throw on, there's like the classic, like Halloween Town ones that I like.
Yeah.
One I watched recently. That's like, people are like, oh, it's a Christmas movie or it's a Halloween movie. I don't know. I think it was like, actually, you know, that's more of a Christmas movie. The Nightmare Before Christmas. Like, but it was just like kind of like both. It's a weird, like dual. It's like a dual.
I've never seen it.
It's weird, man. It's like this guy who lives in like a Halloween world, like transports over to like a Christmas world. And he's all like negative. He's a skeleton, but then he becomes like jolly. Yeah, it's like a nice movie, but it's I don't know which one, which how movie or season it's intended for. Both. It's like a dual holiday movie, but that one is decent. Like if you like Tim Burton movies, Coraline's pretty goddamn creepy.
Yeah, I'm not into scary movies at all. Like, I hate scary movies. So, like, any kind of scary movie that you could possibly list, like, I haven't seen it. So, I wouldn't even know.
Yeah. Man, like, scary movies aren't for everybody. And, like, I had this conversation because we were going to throw on that, like, you know the movie Us by, like, Jordan Peele, the director who does Get Out? Yeah. Like, I was going to throw on that because they'd never seen it. I'm like, oh, it's a pretty good movie. Like, it's more of a thriller than a horror movie.
Okay.
But then, like, we're kind of, like, talking about who likes horror movies and who doesn't. And, like, 90% of my house was like, no, like, I hate them.
Yeah.
Because, like, a lot of the times they put too much emphasis on, like, the pop-outs or whatever, the pop jump scares.
Right.
It's, like, the plots of them are just, like, not it. Like, they just suck.
Mm.
Like, they don't have a good story. Like, there's no good storylines, and it's just, like, eh.
I feel like I just always associate it with, like, paranormal and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Like, those kind of creepy, like, ones where, like, ghosts could be real and all that kind of shit. And it's, like, I just don't like the concept of those. Because regardless of the fact that I know it's not real when I'm watching it, it's, like, I always get that feeling, like, you know when you go in the basement, like, you turn the lights off and then close the door and you, like, run up the stairs. Yeah. And it's, like... It's just like, you know, nothing's going to happen, but it's still like that kind of thought. And then it's like, if you watch one of those movies, even like I see a commercial for that stuff. Or do you remember when you're a kid and people used to put on Ghost Car on YouTube and you'd be watching a car drive down that like mountain really slowly, like waving or going back and forth. And then all of a sudden the pop out would come up on the screen. It was like, I'd close the door in the basement and turn the lights off. And then I would be like, in the back of my head, it was like, that thing's coming for me. And I'm like sprinting up the stairs as fast as I can. And dude, I feel like it's more like the residual effects of those kinds of movies where it's like, I'm laying in bed and I like turn off the lights. And then it's like, it's in this room with me. So like, I can't do it. Like I can't, cause watching the movie itself is probably okay, but it's dealing with it after the fact. I'm like, why would I put myself through that? Like, I don't want
to. Yeah. And like as a kid, I'd go to bed and just be like tossing and turning, like looking under my bed, like for I'm like, oh, this is like, what's the point?
Yeah, it's like you see all those memes of like when you stick your foot out from under the sheets, your one foot just to get some cool down, and then it's like the demon under your bed, like scheming, rubbing his knees together, smiling because your foot's out. Like, yeah, it's like those, and it's like, oh no, I'm not putting any of my like my covers will keep me safe.
Dude, I used to do the, like, after watching a horror movie, the run up to bed, and, like, I didn't want to get too close to the edge of my bed where anything could, like, grab me, so I'd, like, make a leap from, like, four feet out from my bed and jump onto it just to, like, avoid any, like, hands reaching out and grabbing it.
Because that millisecond that you're, like, not looking down at your feet as you're getting into bed is when they're going to grab you, for sure.
Yeah,
so you just jump it, avoid it. Yeah, no, I just don't like the concept of scary movies. Like, I'm not into that. But I think part of it too might be because, like, do you believe in ghosts?
Yeah, I think I do.
Okay, so let me like tell you this and see what your thoughts on it are.
Okay.
So at my grandparents' house, there's a few different things that have happened. So the first, and like you might just think I'm a psychopath, I don't know if I've ever told this on here before, but when I was a baby, we would go over to my grandparents' house. Like, my parents would take us there. They'd put me upstairs in this room to take a nap, and they would come upstairs and find me like standing in the crib talking, like as if I was like talking to somebody. And then they would ask me, like, who are you talking to? And I would say, the man. So that was something that happened when I was like a little kid. Like not even like a little kid, like basically a baby that like just started talking, I guess. So kind of creepy, but regardless, my sisters, they're 3 years younger than me. We start going there and they go up for naps. My parents would find them doing the same thing. And they said they were talking to the man.
No.
Yeah.
That's terrifying.
So this is like the start of it. Then my grandparents have one of those, record players that you have to like put the CD on, lift the pen, put it on, and crank it to play.
Is it the gramophone?
Gramophone, like, yes.
The horn one? Yeah,
I love those. So we'd be in like a different room. No one's in the front room where this thing is, and it would start playing. And it's like you have to literally like lift up the CD, put it on, take the scratcher, I don't know what they're called, but like the scratching thing, put it on the record and then crank it to get it to play, and it would just play. Like, it would just play. Another thing, we'd be downstairs and we kind of had just like, I feel like normally you would just associate it to like how old the house is or like creaking of the house. But like, you'd be downstairs and you'd hear like no windows open, no nothing. And you'd hear like footsteps upstairs. And then you'd hear a door close. Like, no one's upstairs.
Oh my God.
Yeah. So it's like all this stuff going on. And
I don't know what I'd move, man. Have you seen Haunting of Hill House?
No.
That sounds really similar to that shit. But like, I don't know. I'd move.
Yeah. So I don't know. But like, that kind of stuff is like, I feel like that's why almost in a way these paranormal movies and stuff, even though they're not real, it just seems a little more real. Because it's like,
it's a little closer to home.
Yeah. Wait a minute.
I've seen this shit.
I've
seen this shit before.
Yeah, so, I don't know.
That's crazy.
Do you have any stories like that? Any ghost stories or not?
No, well, nothing like that, man. Like, that's just, like, wild. But, man, oh, my God. I'm going to have nightmares tonight.
Yeah, dude.
That's awful. Can we change the subject? Oh, my God, Billy. Holy.
Yeah, sorry, man. Sorry.
No, that's, like, I believe in ghosts, but now I'm even more, like I'm even more convinced. Oh,
yeah.
Oh, my God.
Well, like, there's this thing, too, where my dad's going to see it. And I don't know what it is. Maybe we'll have to have him on at some point to like explain it, or I'll just ask him and like give it in detail. But there's somewhere that he would go with his buddies, and you basically like go out in the forest, and like it's like almost like a tourist thing, because like it's a legend that this happens. And then I guess I'm probably getting it wrong, but like the concept of it is this guy was riding his motorcycle really fast and like what didn't see something, and then like hit the fence and like lost his head or something like that. I don't know. So basically, like if you go in the forest at this time, you see headlights coming towards you and then like tail lights going away. But like there's no like sound or anything like that.
That's wild.
Yeah. Like I'm probably messing it up, and like there's more to it that may adds to it, but like that's kind of the basic concept of it. And I think like it's that he's looking for his head or something like that, like coming back to find his head. Yeah, like stuff like that is just like, oh.
Yeah, that is bone chilling. That is bone chilling. Oh, yeah. My God.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's a lot to process. That's a lot to process, man. Maybe I got to go on like an expedition like that and figure out to get some truth.
Yeah.
I need to, maybe not like, because there's some bullshit ghost hunting stuff on like.
Yeah.
TLC or like the Ghost Hunters, the little TV show they have, but
yeah,
I don't know, man. I think there's some incredible shit out there that stories I've heard and experiences people have had that have, yeah, man. There's some supernatural stuff going on.
Yeah, the real Canadian horror stories or whatever. Do you remember those books?
Yeah, yeah,
yeah. Those used to creep me out too, because they would like read them in school, in elementary school, and like teachers would like read it to us, and I was like, I would just go home and like think about it. There's one that stuck out of like. This person that like lost their thumbs or something, and then their thumbs would like show up, and I would just creep me out because I'd think like that was gonna happen to me, and it was just not a good experience with like ghosts and scary stuff.
Yeah,
like, I don't like that stuff.
No,
it doesn't sit well with me.
What's your favorite part of Halloween? Do you like Halloween then? If you don't like the scary stuff, like overall, what's your overall consensus on the season?
Yeah, I like Halloween. Like I used to like dressing up and going trick or treating and like Halloween music. And I guess for me as a kid, like my grandparents used to always throw these Halloween parties.
Oh,
so
that's
all
awesome.
Of their friends and my parents' friends and like my mom's sister's friends would come over and like have these big parties at my grandparents' house. And like everyone was dressed up. Like they'd have like, I feel like over 100 people in their house,
really?
Just like an adult banger going on. Everyone's dressed up. My sisters and I are all dressed up. And I feel like I'd kind of associate some of it with that. Like my grandpa goes hard for Halloween. He used to have, like, you know, all the blow ups out front, and then he would have the smoke machines coming. Like he'd have dry ice and smoke coming out, music playing with like the mwahaha, like all that stuff going on.
Yeah,
and
that's so awesome.
Like kids would come up to get their stuff, like a big Frankenstein head with candy in it. And so I always like doing that. So I have like positive memories from Halloween. I just don't like the scary stuff of it. Like the dressing up. And then when I got older, like it's less about, there's no trick or treating, and it's just like going to parties and dressing up with your friends and Like, I enjoyed that.
That's awesome. One thing I really like is like being able to see, no matter where you are, like you can be at any Halloween party, but see literally everybody's costumes.
Yeah.
And that's what I like all the stories and like posts and stuff. Like, I love just like sitting there scrolling through them and just like a nice, like,
yeah, Halloween check it out, all the costumes. Yeah. An abundance of photos. I do like it because you see different, all these different costumes, and it's like, oh, that one's creative or that's funny, or like, you see the couple's costumes that aren't the basic salt and pepper ones like we talked about before, and it's like, yeah, nice. Yeah. Like, you guys really thought these ones out, and I like that stuff. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I backed that hard. I love it. It just makes me so happy, like seeing other people like getting fired up and like putting time and effort into their costume. I'm like, yo, that's so cool.
Yeah.
But yeah, I don't know. I like Halloween as well. Like, any excuse I can get to like throw on a costume and drink with my buddies, like, yeah, why not? I mean, that's pretty dope.
Yeah. Yeah. And then just the whole association with candy and stuff too.
Yeah.
Doesn't get much better than that. Much better than that. Do you have any favorite Halloween songs, or like, are there songs that like stick out of Halloween songs more than anything else? Like, the one for me that's like the best Halloween song, in my opinion, is the Monster Mash.
Yeah, the Monster Mash is a classic, because they always used to play that at like I had elementary school like Halloween dances, and they would always play them, that song there and stuff.
Yeah.
Another song like is Thriller. I feel like coincides with Halloween, that I can get behind. But then a lot of other like Halloween songs, I feel like they're just like very like organ based. There's a lot of like organ and like
ominous, yeah, it's just like the creepy
like sound effects. It's like I couldn't tell you the names of them, but I feel like there are a lot of like songs like that are
okay. So I had pulled up prior to this a list of Halloween songs, the best Halloween songs. So here are some of the ones that I found, and we can kind of go through, and like, I feel like some of them aren't really that much Halloween songs, so we can debate. But Monster Mash, obviously, Thriller, Somebody's Watching Me.
Oh,
I think that one's a pretty good one.
That was like an NHL commercial.
Was it?
They had like a commercial like advertising NHL 10 maybe, or NHL like 11, and it was on TV, and they had that song playing in the background.
Interesting. I don't remember that.
I have a weird memory of that.
Heads Will Roll. This is one that's on here, and I'm like, I would not associate that with Halloween. I always associate Heads Will Roll with
Project X.
Yeah, and like getting ready to go to a party. Like, all of last year at school, we watched Project X at the very beginning of the year, and every single time we were praying, because we had that massive speaker in the house, and it like, you could crank the bass on it, we would just blare Heads Will Roll, and like everyone's in the room is just getting fired up to Heads Will Roll, like drinking. Yeah. Like, I don't associate that with Halloween at all. Like, it's just a drinking.
No, I wouldn't either.
Song,
yeah,
almost.
It's just a fire up tune.
This one I've never even heard of. A Nightmare on My Street, DJ Jazzy Jeff. No, never heard of it.
I think Before Our Time, maybe.
Yeah. The Reaper by Blue Oyster Cult.
Oh yeah, Don't Fear the Reaper. Yeah, I know that tune. It's not a Halloween song though. Like,
right.
It's just like, I don't know, man. Like, I wouldn't, it's not a Halloween song in my books.
Yeah. Like, okay. That's like this next one for me. Superstition, Stevie Wonder.
Like, what list is this?
I would never have like associated that. Then there's like Howlin' for You by the Black Keys.
It's about a wolf, but like,
I didn't think about this one. I just came across it. Okay. Feed My Frankenstein, Alice Cooper. I think that's a good Halloween song.
Yeah.
It's not specific to Halloween, but it's good. Like, it's Feed My Frankenstein. Like, yeah, it's just dialed for Halloween. It's perfect.
Yeah, okay. That's the only one I think we can really take from this list. The other one's like Superstition by Stevie Wonder. Give me a break.
Yeah, no.
That's a Halloween song. Yeah.
That one's bad. Come on. That's bad, man.
That's just laziness.
Yeah, that is sheer laziness. Like, what the hell? Superstition by Stevie Wonder. What is that? How is that a Halloween song?
It's like, yeah, he's probably just listening to it in his headphones as he's writing it. Like, yeah, like, why not?
Yeah.
Throws it in.
Halloween. Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, yeah. That's
a joke.
But yeah, I think like Monster Mash has got to be my number one. It's just so good. It's so good. I think that's enough of the Halloween topics, McGee. Do you got any better for us?
Wait, oh. I do. Okay. This may be a controversial be better, so okay. I'm gonna keep it short and sweet. It goes back to, obviously, like I said earlier, I love costumes. I love seeing people get creative with the costumes. I love seeing people have fun with their costumes.
Yeah.
The one thing I'm going to say is that mostly women tend to get a little provocative for Halloween and express themselves, which is dope. But there's a limit. If you're literally just I saw somebody on Snapchat, not naming any names, but if you're listening, you know who you are, posted a Snapchat story, not even a private story or anything, just a Snapchat story of just roommates' underwear and nothing else. And I was like, what are you supposed to be? Is that a costume? Or are you just showing off?
Yeah.
I don't know. I was confused. It was literally just underwear. I'm like, oh, right on. Maybe it wouldn't be my pick to post on a public story, but hey, do you, that's okay.
Yeah.
And I mean, if she's comfortable posting that, that's dope. Do your thing. But I think she needs to be better. That's just my humble opinion. I think wear a costume. It's October. You're probably going to go outside maybe, but if not, I don't know.
Yeah. I agree. Better. I think the people who are think it's lame to dress up, those people need to be better. You're lame for not dressing up. In the spirit.
Even wearing anything.
No, that's clothes. So lazy. That's just a joke. It's a mockery of Halloween.
Yeah, it
is. Be better. Show some decorum. Put on a costume. Figure it out. Show some respect to the holiday.
If you're, show some respect to the holiday. If you're going to do that, you do it, but maybe you do it privately or post on a private story. Because I'm not even close with this person. I was kind of shocked, to be honest.
Yeah.
Pardon me?
Yeah, wait, what?
Oh my God. Yeah. Sorry, what did I just see? Did I black out for a sec? Yeah, no, I don't know. Be better.
All right. Episode 55. You got a crank lad of the week here?
I do. I think, I really like that battle thing we do at the beginning of episodes now, and we got to keep that going with various challenges. So he has been named Lad of the Week previously.
Yeah.
But he has not yet been the Crank Lad of the Week. So I think this episode's Crank Lad of the Week has to go to Benny OC for the great feedback with their content. I think we have to.
I think it's a good one, man. Being able to provide us with a debate topic like that, we can almost throw that in there and call it a master debate or something. It's just a good topic. It's interesting to debate. I can't wait to see what else we can
come up with.
Yeah. What other competitions and athletes we can put head to head, because we're not just going to compete them in their own sport or even a sport necessarily. Maybe we'll do who would win at Connect Four. You never know what we're going to come up with here.
Yeah.
So it's a great topic, great contribution from one of the original lads, a guy who just listens every week. He came in and filled in as a co-host for you on one of the episodes.
Exactly. Yeah.
Returned the following week to give us an update on how some things went. Great lad. Just good content altogether. So Benny OC, episode 55, Crank Lad of the Week. But yeah, that about does it, McGee.
Yeah, that about does it. And I'd just like to add before we go, it's been a crazy, crazy couple past weeks. I mean, we got the midterm seasons coming through, busy time of year with holidays, Thanksgiving, rolling into Halloween.
Yeah.
And it's been hectic. So we haven't really gotten on our horse guests-wise in terms of reaching out to new people. However, we're back, baby. We got more big things coming, more stuff that we're working towards, and it's only up from here, man. So I'm super excited about that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It just gets better and better.
Yeah. So make sure you subscribe to our Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Go check out our YouTube. I recently started to like break it down so you can actually see playlists of our this or that and our be better segments. So if you want to see those things broken out and like just watch a couple minute clips of what's going on, those are going to be there and those are going to be available. If you want to see full episodes, those are still always up. They go up every Monday with our episode releases. But yeah, go like, comment, subscribe, share, review, whatever you got to do. Put it out there. Help us help you.
Yeah.
So kind of said it better myself.
Yeah. Go check out all of our different platforms. But yeah, that's about it, McGee.
That's 55. About it.
The Ryan McGee episode.
Yeah. I don't think you should call it that. I don't think anybody would listen, but thanks guys for your continued support over these past 55 episodes. Onwards and upwards, only get better from here. Like we said, we're going to get more personal, share our playlists, do all this stuff, kind of break things down and make it easy, like more digestible and just kind of more accessible.
Yeah.
And yeah, please keep on coming at us with that feedback. It's always appreciated. And we look forward to your continued support in the future. So catch us next episode, 56. Same time, same place, same lawn chairs. Cheers, lads and ladettes.
Cheers.